16 hits in total as they crushed the Cubs 11-3. The Cardinals pitched well, allowing only 3 hits as they got the best of the...
Switching up my energy. My enemies feel like I got hundreds of them. No love for me. Y'all ain't in the streets. Y'all is in the street. Y'all take ministry.
He said, no deal. I like the breach. I call up my lawyer like never mind. They playing with all three. It's just money. Three.
Welcome in, everyone. Second inning of our ball game with two away.
That exists.
The first so baseman. Next to bat will be Brady Staal, as the switch hitter will bat right-handed here.
This guy loves hitting right-handed against left-handed pitching, hitting over 350 on the year against left-handed pitching.
Well, this Yankee ball club entering play this afternoon here. They come in as hot as anyone in this first week of the season as they've won 5 of their first 6 contests.
Yeah, Maddie, this team is playing well right now, and they got their ace on the mound. This guy has unbelievable stuff. And I can't underestimate the fact that this is a day game. We are creatures of habit. Guys are used to playing 7 o'clock games at night and rolling out of bed around 12, 1 o'clock and heading to the yard. Instead, they're going to get stuff thrown down their throat right at that time. I hope these guys got out of bed and got a few cups of coffee in them.
Just hung in there on that one. Here he comes again, 1-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Judge is on the move. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Now, here's the first pitch to him. Brady Staal is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Oh, pretty healthy hack one, that one. Time. It's 1-1.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
High and wide, two balls and a strike. crushed that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. He'll try it again, 3-2. Hit high and deep out to left field. You can kiss it goodbye. A solo shot here to left. Home run number 3 here in the early going. As they cut the lead in half, it's 2-1 now. Down in the record books, he's hit their first homer since moving to their new hometown.
This pitcher is doing his job right here, but also the offense is obviously not picking anything up today.
Here comes the 0-1. Bonnie looked like a caveman swinging a club on that one. It's 0-2 now.
He's still looking great to me out there on the mound. Punched out the first guy in the seventh, and he's jumped ahead in the count right here. Looks like he could stay in this game a while longer.
And he struck him out, and that's 8 strikeouts thus far.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Now pitching for New York. Number 54. Johnson.
Bring in the winning run. The question is whether they'll even pitch to him. Here's the first pitch.
This has to be a productive at-bat right here. I know you want to drive the run in and get the RBI, but you have to find a way, bare minimum, to move this runner over to third.
The 1-0. Too much bite on the sinker, and he's behind 2-0 now.
Clearly staying away from him in this at-bat with that runner in scoring position tells me they're trying to force him to reach for something and maybe roll over on it.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
I always remember John Smoltz telling me the greatest asset a closer can have is short-term memory. And this situation calls for it right here. He's got to forget that he has any traffic on a base pass and just attack the zone.
Here's the 2-2 pitch. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2. Kyle Murray will be next. Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. Unbelievable! A home run! I don't believe what I just saw! I don't believe what I just saw! So a two-run shot to left center, and with one swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
Looking for that one guy to step up and be that hero. And this guy was the hero tonight. What does he do? Steps up with a walk-off home run to end this thing in extras.
For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Here now is our final line score.
Tuning in. We're in the second inning here with one man out.
Batting six.
Now at the plate, Brady Staal, as the switch hitter will bat right-handed here.
Even though he's batting right-handed in this particular bat, this guy swings it from both sides of the plate. Numbers pretty much the same across the board. A terrific hitter right-handed in this at-bat, but if you try to switch this guy around from the left side, he can do some damage also.
Yankees lead this 1-0 here in inning number two. Not quite reaching 90 with the fastball, but it's 1-1 now. Ruth is coming up on a nice milestone in his career. He's just a small handful of victories away from 100 in his time at the major league level. The 1-1. Is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Wow, what makes it so tough to be a hitter is to be able to hit and change his speeds, right? You're geared up for the fastball, and all of a sudden, he pulls the string and throws you the straight change, the dreaded equalizer.
And he fouls this one off. For the corner in left, it has the distance, and it's a foul ball.
Huge swing of the bat right there, just hooking foul. Would have tied the game. I know there's still a lot of game left, but that was potentially a huge momentum swing there. Gonna have to find a way to refocus and continue this at bat.
One out, nobody on. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Judge is under it. Two down.
Batting seven. The left fielder. Kyle.
So now into the five.
Out. He's out. Three. Yeah. Ball four. Takes away. Three. Four, take the base. He's out. Three. Out. Three. He's out.
Fastball on the inner third, taken for a strike. Oh. It looked like the fastball got away from him there.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
One and one. Here it is. Hit high in the air. There it goes. See ya.
Two bombs yesterday and another long bomb so far today.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the New York Yankees. Number 28, Corey Kluber.
Fly ball out toward left center field. Mantle is there, two gone.
The left fielder, number two, Kyle Murray.
Next up is Brady Staal, flew out last time up.
Almost, Maddie, almost went deep his last AB, certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Got him through that one, but he's in a quick hold, 0-2.
Looks to me like he's just trying to do too much up there at the plate. That's an easy trap to fall into when you're the tying run, but you can't be chasing pitches out of the zone.
A ball and two strikes now. Outside and low that time. Now it's two balls and two strikes.
Well, he kind of got caught chasing the first two pitches out of the strike zone, but I think he's caught on to their game a little bit right now. Two tough pitches that he took with two strikes, and now the count is 2-2.
And he strikes him out as well. So two punch outs to begin the outing out of the pen.
The left
you have to feel
two.
Pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up. Was a fun one to watch. A great game for guys with the sticks, but for pitchers, not so much. A classic slugfest, and they walk away on top in the end.
11-10. Everyone, second inning of our ball game with two away.
The third baseman
at the plate now is Brady Staal. He had a homer. the ballgame yesterday afternoon. He's set, and the pitch. And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. Well, this Yankee ball club entering play this afternoon here, they've been playing some pretty good baseball of late as they've won six of their last eight games.
Hey, thanks, Matty. Hey, you know what, D-Roll? Try to get on a kind of a little mini winning streak here. Losing the first game of this series, winning game two, and hopefully winning this series by pulling one out here today.
Yeah, Dan, they were able to shower that first loss off in the first game of this series and had a nice bounce back game yesterday. Let's see if they can steal the series right here.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Fouled off. The next 0-2. Fouled away. Here comes another 0-2. Got him swinging in the dirt. Berra is after it. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Stepping up is Brady Staal. He went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Brady Staal.
First delivery to him. And great extension as he drives this one high in the air and deep the other way. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
The batter number 8.
Next up, Omar Garcia.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now pitching, Jeremy Jeffress.
Full pitcher base. Hey now.
Next, it'll be Brady Staal. He flew out in his last AB.
Third baseman, Brady Staal.
Now the first pitch. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. Mattingly is off of first with two away. And it's fouled away. Cole sets. Here's the 1-1. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Trying to send him packing for the second time. Swung on in the dirt, strike three. Berra gathers, and the throw to first ends the inning.
Your attention, please. Now pitching, David Robertson.
Three.
switch hitter, Brady Staal, comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. First offering on its way. And a strike called at the knees. Nothing in one. In the dirt here. And this one's inside and high. One and two now.
If I'm in the box, you take a step out right here. Take a deep breath after that high fastball. You got to be leery of him burying something in the dirt.
Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Popped up. Martinez is under it. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
You might think it's just another win, but it's awfully hard to win in this game, especially on the road. But they find a way to get it done, and they should be very happy with this performance.
It's Monday morning, and welcome to Inside the Show. Looking first at the American League East, the New York Yankees knocked out 12 hits as a team as they beat the Butchers 8-3. As of today, the Butchers are in third place in the AL East, while the Yankees are atop the division. The Orioles finished off a two-game sweep as they beat the visiting Red Sox 4-3. At the start of the day, the Orioles sit in last place in the American League East division, and the Red Sox are third in the division. The Blue Jays held their opponent to just two hits as they defeated the visiting Angels 6-0. Heading into the day, the Blue Jays sit in second place in the American League East Division, and the Angels sit in first place in the American League West Division. The Chicago White Sox grabbed the win against the visiting Royals 3-2. As of right now, the White Sox are in third place in the AL Central, while the Royals are third in the division. The Detroit Tigers held the opposition at bay with only four hits as they beat the Tribe in Cleveland 1-0. Entering the day's action, the Indians are in second place in the AL Central, and the Tigers are at the bottom of the division. The Twins hit three long balls as they took down the visiting Mariners 6-4. In the standings, the Twins are leading the American League Central Division, and the Mariners are in fourth place in the AL West. The San Diego Padres grabbed 13 hits in the game as they got the win in a laugher against the Rangers 10-3. As of today, the Rangers are in last place in the AL West, while the Padres are in fourth place in the NL West. The Phillies picked up 14 hits in total as they beat the Braves in Atlanta 10-5. As of right now, the Braves sit in second place in the National League East Division, and the Phillies are third in the division. The Mets knocked out 10 hits as a team as they beat the visiting Marlins 5-3. Entering the day's action, the Mets are atop the National League East division, while the Marlins are fourth in the division. The Chicago Cubs completed a short two-game sweep as they defeated the Pirates at PNC Park 2-0. In the standings, the Pirates sit in first place in the National League Central division, while the Cubs are atop the division. The St. Louis Cardinals finished off a two-game sweep as they got the best of the Brewers at home 6-5. At the start of the day, the Cardinals are in first place in the NL Central, while the Brewers are at the bottom of the division. The Cincinnati Reds totaled 13 hits as a team as they got a road win against Arizona 10-6. Heading into the day, the Diamondbacks sit in third place in the National League West Division, while the Reds are atop the NL Central. The Dodgers brought out the brooms in a three-game sweep as they bested the visiting Nats 5-4. They stayed hot with their 10th in a row. As of today, the Dodgers are atop the NL West, while the Nationals are in last place in the NL East. The Giants totaled 11 hits as they bested the visiting Rockies 6-2. In the standings, the Giants are in second place in the NL West, while the Rockies are at the bottom of the division. That's all for today's show. See you back here tomorrow. Have a great day.